Welcome to the Power Talk Show with me, Dominic, and today we are back after two shows, and I hope you had a great Christmas and that you got blessed over the Christmas. I don't know what you did. I hope you had some, at least some fun and get to relax. And at the end of the day, remember, it is Christmas. It's all about Christ. So it doesn't mean that you can only not have celebrated Christmas if there was no Christ in it, okay? So Christmas is about Him. So it doesn't matter whether or not you're able to eat your favorite food or go to the place you've dreamt of. The most important thing is at least you got time to relax and to be with God in some form or the other. And I also want to wish you a very, very happy 2020. We are in a whole new decade. And I hope this new decade becomes a time for favor and blessings, and becomes a time that you reach the goal that you've been dreaming about. And today I've got some great guests, and first of all, my favorite people from Nibs. Make some noise, people. Make some noise for yourselves. Yeah, it's been a while. Yeah, yeah. Even some people from Nibs are clapping, but it's okay. And then we've got Dan. Huh? Dan and his better half, and the band are here in the studio. So make some noise for Dan. Yeah, he's here. Dan will be performing for us. And then, of course, I've got my guest today, Mr. Anastasio Nyaga, who is a youth mentor. And Mr. Anastasio Nyaga will be helping us to, kind of giving us some advice on how we can live courageously, which is the topic of today. He's going to be giving us some advice. He's going to be telling us how we can organize ourselves and put ourselves in order so that 2020 can be that year that will be a source of, be blessings and will be favor and will be everything that we have dreamt about. And as I've mentioned to you, we are talking about living courageously. And, the word courageous means from the heart, like from the heart, courageous, strongly. And I think one of the biggest problems we have is when we are too comfortable, when we refuse to take risks, when we don't want to see beyond the comfort of where we are at. This year, try to live a bit more courageously by getting out of your comfort zone. And the problem of living the comfort zone is it's going to be scary. You're going to be fearful, and you're going to make mistakes. And let me tell you something. If you are not making mistakes, that means you're not living, because mistakes are part of being human. The problem is, are you searching for those mistakes, or are you making those mistakes carelessly, or are you making those mistakes in the process of doing something good? Now, that is courageous. Remember stories like Abraham and Moses and even Jesus himself and all the people that you admire. These people at some point had to be courageous. They had to stop being comfortable complaining and blaming something, or blaming the society, or blaming where they were born, blaming the, how they grew up in a family where that was broken, that their parents were fighting, or that was too poor. All this for sure can affect how fast we reach our dreams. They can affect how fast. No, they cannot prevent us from getting to our dreams. And you need to be courageous and say, this has been my story until now, and I'm going to change this. And I'm going to change this in my own little way. And can you imagine if each one of us was to live up courageously? Can you imagine what Kenya would be if each one of us was to aim for the highest good and then direct our lives towards it every single day? All right, that would be amazing. Amazing from the leadership to our communities to wherever we find ourselves. So, in every new year, people make resolutions. And I hope you have made some resolutions, and maybe you don't believe in resolutions. Please go to our Facebook page and tell me if you made some resolutions. Share with us some of those resolutions. And if you don't believe in making resolutions, tell me why you don't believe in making resolutions. I'll be reading out your comments, questions, and suggestions in a few. And all that will be on our Facebook page at Y254 channel. So please do that. And I'll be reading those comments in a few. And as I mentioned to you, we've got Dan on the show, and he's going to be performing three pieces of songs for us. And I hope you'll enjoy them. Dan. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
This is the Power Talk Show. It's your first time, right?
Yeah, my first time to be here. And so, I appreciate
it. And you're enjoying it so far?
Yeah, thank
you. We want
for
to enjoy your talent.
All right. I hope so.
Yeah,
hope,
yes. I'm sure you've got some great things coming.
I hope so.
What kind of music do you sing?
I sing Christian music.
Christian music?
Yeah, all gospel right. Music per se.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, that is my line of focus.
Now that you have mentioned the gospel, are you a little afraid of sometimes of what gospel artists do to gospel music, or what gospel music has become? Sometimes there is that bit of criticism that, you know, gospel artists, you know, they have become a bit too secular. They have, you know, they have hidden lives that sometimes come out in a very scary way. Yeah. You know, do you get worried about this?
Yeah, definitely I do worry. I get worried because I'm concerned as not only a musician, but a minister of the gospel. But again, when you look in the scriptures, it's clear that even Jesus said, let the weed and the tare, they will grow to, you know, they will grow together. So, but it's only him who can make the right judgment. But again, we can see again, and we can be able to tell by the fruits that they bear.
Yeah.
You can tell, obviously, who is serving themselves or who is serving the Lord.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
That's amazing. Mm. So you go for it. Let's see what you've got.
All right.
All right.
Hi, everyone.
Hello.
My name is Dan Kahia, and I'm happy to be here. So I want to play the first song. It's a song that I'm still struggling with, learning the lyrics, rather. But it's one of my favorite songs that I thought could be a really nice song to start the year with, because it's called You Made A Way. Pretty popular, isn't it? So I think we know it. So you guys will help me sing along, right?
Perfect.
Yeah.
Go for it.
All right. Standing here, not knowing how to get through this test, but holding on to the faith that we know, nothing can catch you by surprise. You've got this figured out, you're working it out. And when we think that we cannot win, you wrap us in your arms and step in. Everything you need, you supply. You've got this figured out, you're working it now, 'cause you made a way. When I back against the wall and it look as if it was over, you made a way. And you're standing here only because you made, 'cause you made a way. Back against the wall and it look as if it was over, you made a way. And we're standing here only because you made, let me say, 'cause you made a way. You made a when I back against the wall and it look as if it was over, you made a way. And we're standing here only because you made a way. Let me sing. 'Cause you move mountains, you cause walls to fall in your power. It's upon miracles, there is nothing that's impossible. And we're standing here only because you move mountains, you cause walls to fall in your power. You perform miracles, there is nothing that's impossible. And we're standing here only because you made, 'cause you made a way. When I back against the wall and it looked as if it was over, you made a way. And we're standing here only because you made a way.
Good stuff, man. Very good stuff.
Thank you.
We'll be coming back to you on that. You starting an IEO, you know, praying that God will make a way, and He is making a way, and I hope He is making a way for you. And I can see also there is already a few comments that have come in, and I'm going to actually read them even before we start our conversation. I asked the question, you know, a very happy new year 2020. Do you believe in making some resolutions? Share with us some of your resolutions. And I read a few, and one is quite interesting. So there is Anthony Kabia saying, "Mai ni kuacha pombe mazee." Yeah, muhimu mazee. Yeah, 2020, napunguza party after party. By now, ningekuwa ta one of the tycoons. Yeah, that's a good one. Yeah, that's a good one. Even for your health. Huh? Okay. Aisha Aji, to accomplish the resolutions I made last year. Kwa hivyo wewe, Aisha, your resolution is to accomplish last year's resolutions. Nice one. Okay. Mumia Isaiah Bonventure, my resolution is not to make any resolution that I can't keep. Okay, no, that's a good one, that you're not going to make a resolution that you cannot keep. Good one. Hey, Doris Denik, ndiye amesema hapa, amesema in 2020, Y254, please change your boring programs. Haki ya nani? Yani, hata ya ntasoma tu, mimi sina ubaya. Hey, Doris, change kidogo manze, your resolution should be to be kind. Okay. Rez Music, hii ndiyo hii anakam interview hapo kwa ubaya. Welcome, Reza. I'll be very happy to interview you. Share with us some of your a story or the song or whatever you do, and definitely I'll host you. Kale Kamze Manu, buying 2 Madrids, and hope God will give me courage to do it. Definitely, I'm sure God is gonna give you the courage. I hope you'll take advantage of the courage that He's gonna give you so that you can do something. Remember, we're talking about living courageously. How can you live more courageously this year? And as I've mentioned to you today, I've got Anastasio Nyaga, who is a youth mentor and a lecturer. Welcome to the show.
Thank you.
Welcome back. This is not the first time you have been here.
Not the first time. Not first time, of course.
Yes.
Yes.
I hear Miguna is back.
You hear that?
Yes. That's the news that I've just come. I'm not sure.
Yes.
But
yes,
I'm
yes.
Hearing he's back.
Maybe a rumor. Maybe a true rumor also.
Do you think it is fair so far? What has been that's been the case according to you? I'm not watching Mushene.
Twice a missionary for now. We don't start the new year with missionary, of course.
Let's speak about something even more important.
Yes.
Iran and USA.
Yes. That's more important?
Yeah, very important, Buana. Those bombs
me, I'm just fearing the third world war.
That's the thing.
Fearing the third world war. So it's not so important, actually.
If it happens.
Yes. We pray that it may not happen.
You remember that story of when two bulls fight?
Yes.
Who suffers?
Grass.
The grass.
Yes.
These we are the grass boys.
And we are going to suffer. That's why we are praying that it may not. These are not good news not at good the beginning news. Of the year.
Hey, Buana.
Yes.
Hey,
yes. Buana. We God forbid.
God forbid.
Yes.
So for you, I'm sure it's 2020. First of all, Happy New Year.
Same to you.
Being 2020, it means you have lived across 4 decades. For you in your 40s.
Yeah, 4 decades. Yes.
Four decades.
Yes.
And 2 centuries.
Of course, yes. Yeah, because last century and this
of course,
century,
not,
yes.
Not these people. These were this century only.
Yeah, this century.
This century. The year 2000.
Yeah. So where I can see now seated, uh-huh. They may not see studying.
No, oh yeah, for sure. For
the
sure.
Old, yeah.
And actually, that's why you're here to help us understand that.
Yeah? Yes.
Because it said the old man seated can see way far than a young man on a tree.
On a tree.
Yeah, that's a good African proverb.
Yes.
African proverbs sometimes they're just crazy. So mtu alikaa chini hivi akafikiria ati mzee akiwa ameketi kwa kiti.
Anaona mbali.
Anaona mbali.
Na wakati mwingi hata aoni.
It's a Kikuyu proverb, isn't it?
It's a Kikuyu proverb.
Moduri.
Mudhe.
Guka.
Guka.
Aikarire gete. Onaga kuraihu.
Kuraihu.
Wokira mo kehe.
Kehe.
Kemote igoro.
Kana modu mwethe.
One. Modu mwethe.
Modu mwethe.
Let's come back. Sorry, that was just one of the national languages that we have. Okay. So, living courageously.
Yes.
We're talking about that. You know, in 2020, We are still in the beginning.
Yes.
The very first week.
Yes, very first week.
And what we want to, in this conversation, is to help young people.
Yes.
To, everybody who is watching anyway.
Yeah.
To make the most of 2020.
Mm.
All right?
Yes.
Now, first of all, one of the most common practices is making resolutions.
Resolutions, yes.
Do you believe in making resolutions?
Sure. Why? I believe in making resolutions.
Why?
You
Why
know,
do you think that it helps?
Yeah. Resolutions, mm-hmm. actually, there is like a road mark. It's a path
uh-huh.
that guides you, yeah, where you are to go
mm.
for a particular period.
Okay.
Like now when I was leaving home,
mm-hmm.
I had my roadmap to come here.
Yeah.
So a resolution is like a roadmap that I make.
A map. You a mean map. A map? Uh-huh. Yes. Roadmap, okay.
Yes, mm. a roadmap mm-hmm. that I make
uh-huh.
that helps me. Yeah.
So if I make a resolution, maybe I've been making a resolution since 2015,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
I make resolutions in 2015.
Yes.
By the 3rd of January, yeah. I cannot even remember those resolutions.
Yeah.
I'm not practicing them.
Yes.
It happens in 2016, in 2017, and 2018. Why should I continue doing these things? Siniendelee tu na maisha, ni siku imebadilika.
Hapana.
Jana ilikuwa Tuesday.
Yes.
That the first as a new first
Yes.
January. Where should I?
I should not say that you should stop.
Uh-huh.
You know, there's a saying, never give up. You see, what I was not able to accomplish yesterday,
mm-hmm.
I may be able to accomplish today.
Okay.
I keep hoping and striving
mm-hmm.
for the best
mm-hmm.
and making more resolutions. St. Paul says, when I am weak, I'm strong. When I fall, it's only that I can get up.
Mm-hmm.
So I should not be afraid of breaking the resolutions that I made. The only way is to see why I broke it
mm-hmm.
and then see in which way can I pick up the pieces again mm-hmm. and move.
So if I break my resolutions, yeah. what do? I try again? That's what you're saying?
I try again, uh-huh, yes. Uh-huh. I try again. Or maybe I made a resolution that was not practical.
Do you think there are some? I think that's a good example of the question I wanted to ask.
Yes.
So what are some of these reasons that make people not to keep the resolutions? I think one of them is people make too many.
Too many.
Uh-huh.
That's one.
Mm-hmm.
Also, you make a resolution that is not concrete.
It's not concrete.
Yes.
Okay. What do you mean by that? Not
For
concrete.
For example, mm-hmm. if you say mm-hmm. by the end of this year I want to go to America.
Okay.
Yeah.
Possible,
I think that's a big dream.
It is.
Maybe better say
uh-huh.
I want to
Go
visit
to Tanzania.
Maybe Tanzania or okay. even Installation Garden.
So
yeah, maybe I've never been to Installation Garden, isn't it?
If I'm making what you're saying is if I'm making a resolution,
yeah.
like to go to the US,
yes.
and all my savings are 100 bob,
yes,
or 1,000 shillings,
yes,
and flying to the US and maybe is 120,000,
yes,
and return to and fro,
yes, to and yeah? fro, yes.
So you're saying that is not very realistic.
It's not very realistic,
okay,
because I'm comparing it with my capability mm-hmm. of reaching there.
Okay.
Yes.
So first of all, I should make a resolution of something that I can achieve. You can achieve.
Something
that's achievable. Okay.
That's achievable.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, so for you, you're saying they are important because they provide a roadmap.
A roadmap.
So that you're not just groping in the dark.
Yes.
Uh-huh. So
you have a guide, mm-hmm. a compass. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
Very good. So what are some of the resolutions
yeah.
that a good example, maybe yeah. That you can give
yeah.
that young people can make.
Yes.
That can help them
yes.
to live more courageously. What you know, yeah. some of them.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. For example, a young person can make a resolution
mm-hmm.
to change friends.
Okay.
Maybe I have been working with a group that is not making me realize my dreams. That's always is making me maybe not able to keep what I promised myself.
Okay.
And therefore, I need to choose friends. Friends who can encourage me, for example. Friends who can even uplift me.
Who believe in you.
Who believes in me.
Mm-hmm. And who can criticize you.
Even who can criticize me mm-hmm. positively, no?
Yep.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah. Those who can criticize me also mm-hmm. positively.
Perfect.
Yeah. So a resolution can be this in this year, I want to be careful about choosing friends.
And that takes a lot of courage.
Yes.
That takes a lot of courage
because
it means I am moving
yeah.
from people
yeah.
and finding others.
Yes.
And these people I'm leaving, they can judge me for being proud. Squeeze unajifanya, hatawezi hang out na sisi.
And yes.
You know, and then you're moving to new people that you do not know.
Yes.
And you don't know if they will like you back.
They will like you. It's a risk.
It's a risk. So it takes courage.
It involves risk.
Wow. Okay. Yes. So changing friends. So we can say high quality friends leads to high quality life.
Life.
Okay.
Sure.
Fantastic. Yes. Uh-huh. Number two.
Mm. I think also believing in oneself can contribute to the to living a courageous life.
Okay.
You see, I read in one book, mm-hmm. Burns, Dege, mm-hmm. fly because they believe they can.
Okay.
They think they can fly.
So you're saying a chicken doesn't fly because it doesn't believe it can?
Possibly.
Possibly.
You know that story of a chicken and eagle, no?
Yeah, tell me about it.
That story that a farmer collected an egg
okay.
of an eagle. Mm-hmm. And went and put together with the eggs of a chicken.
Okay.
And eventually they hatched together with the eggs of the
with the chicken.
Uh-huh. And they were growing together as chicks.
Okay.
But remember one of the eggs was the egg of
an eagle.
Mm. So there was a chick of an eagle. Mm-hmm. And as they were growing together, mm-hmm. every chick thought is like other chick.
Okay.
Yeah?
Yeah.
One day, there was a person who came and told that chick, mm-hmm. you know, you are not a chick. Mm-hmm. You are an eagle.
Okay.
Yeah? And also, it could not believe.
I mean, this is a story, right?
Yes, a story.
Ah, okay.
Of course,
because
it's a story.
I'm wondering,
this
ego is speaking.
It's a story, of course.
Oh, okay.
It could be a fiction story also.
Yes,
but it has a great lesson.
Yes,
no?
Please. Okay, sure.
And when that farmer raised that ego, mm-hmm. you know, somewhere on top, mm-hmm. the ego was trying to?
To fly.
Mm. And it realized that it could fly far. Uh-huh. And the chicks were just looking at it like this. I tend to think even the chicks themselves, mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. if they believe they could do so,
they could fly. That's a good point. So
believing in oneself can make great things happen.
Yes. So I think this point is actually connected to the first, insofar as if you are an eagle and you are staying with chicks, you will never fly. All right.
Yes.
So you need to believe in yourself.
Yeah, and look for other egos.
So can we say in this story of yours, this man who comes and reminds or teaches this ego that you're actually an ego, is kind of a mentor, someone to work with you?
It's a mentor.
Is this a good? Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay.
In fact, yes. Mm-hmm. It's a mentor trying to help this ego to realize its potentials, mm-hmm. potentialities, capabilities. Yeah. And I think also, mm-hmm. The young people need to have mentors who can help them also when they realize life is becoming too cumbersome for them. Yeah. Because as young people have also gone through the same,
Absolutely.
There are times life is really very, very difficult.
Absolutely.
Very discouraging, so to say. Mm. We are talking about being courageous, but life itself just turned the other way around.
Absolutely.
So that's a moment that we need to have someone who says, look here, I find my life is just, you know, just getting torn, you know, and what can I do?
Mm.
Yeah.
So I need to look for someone I can open my heart to sometimes.
Yes.
And speak to about the challenge that I'm going through. And I think if you cannot get someone like this, you can even write it down, I guess.
You can write it down.
It works.
Yes.
And a mentor, as I've mentioned, I think even here before I've mentioned that a mentor can be someone also who is online, you know.
Yeah.
It can be video clips that you watch on YouTube, you know, or books that you read, you know, of some certain author.
Yes.
And that person becomes a sort of your mentor.
Yes.
That's fantastic.
Sure.
Now, there is something that has come to my mind about this ego and chicken, you know.
Yeah.
Sometimes when you want to fly away, but the people who are willing to accept you and love you are the chicks. You want to be an ego.
Yes.
But the people that love you are chicks.
Yes.
All right?
Yeah.
So sometimes when you fly, it becomes very lonely.
Very lonely.
It becomes lonely.
Yes.
And you are, you're getting criticized.
Yes.
And sometimes you want to go back to the comfort, at least, of being loved by
even these.
It's like, let's say you're in two people in a bad relationship, okay?
Yeah.
So one of them does not want maybe the, let me say, the lady realizes that she's in a bad relationship.
Yes.
But she's like, I've been in this relationship for 5 years.
Yeah.
Okay?
Yeah.
If I go out there, am I sure if someone will love me? And then she, maybe she even tries to break up for a while.
Right.
Then goes out there for 2-3 months.
Yeah.
She's not able to get into a new relationship, yeah, and all that. She knows the relationship she's in is bad.
Yes, bad.
But
yes,
it's better,
yeah,
than not having somebody.
Comfort, yes.
You know,
yes,
than not having somebody. So in this context, yeah, what can one do,
yeah,
when the discomfort of trying to fly away becomes lonely and tiring,
yeah,
and
yes,
become criticized? What should you do in that?
Yeah. Yeah. One of the things I usually advise young people, mm-hmm, is to join groups or clubs that help him or her to journey in the right path. In these groups, many times there are workshops,
mm-hmm,
there are seminars, and you realize people will share their experiences.
Mm-hmm.
That's where sometimes you realize maybe my story is like the story of another. You may think that you are alone, suffering alone,
mm-hmm,
but you may realize that there's another person having the same story.
Absolutely.
Yeah?
Mm.
And then sharing the experiences, you'll find a way out. Maybe the person shares how he or she was able to come out of the problem.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
And from there you see, this is also how I can try to,
absolutely,
come out of,
yeah,
this.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Living a, so to say, lonely life,
mm-hmm,
is very dangerous. Dangerous in the sense, whatever you think becomes right.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Because there's no one to challenge it.
There's no one to challenge you.
Mm.
No one to challenge you. In fact, I there's another point I want to really put forward to young people, that we need very much to control our thought life.
Mm-hmm.
What we think of ourselves and also of the others.
What we think we become.
You become, sure.
Mm-hmm.
And what we think the others think of us.
Mm-hmm.
You see, like now, if I think you are not appreciating me,
mm-hmm,
it may be a false thinking that, mm-hmm, you are not appreciating me.
Such that even if I appreciate you, you think I'm lying.
Yes, yeah, you are lying.
Yeah.
Or I think that maybe you're bluffing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So I need to take positive thinking about myself,
mm-hmm,
and where I sometimes I don't need to care too much what, mm-hmm, other people say
think,
about,
yeah,
me.
Yeah, correct, correct.
Yeah?
Yeah.
As long as I know,
mm-hmm,
that I'm striving to be on the right path.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So it's a good point. So
yeah,
to you know, there's someone who say that I'm not a Facebook page, you don't have to like me, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
I'm,
yeah,
not,
yeah,
a Facebook page, you don't have
to like me.
You know?
Yes.
Yeah, so I can be independent.
Yes.
I can think for myself.
For myself.
I don't have to be a sheep.
Yes.
You know, that's what you're saying. Okay,
yes,
very,
yes,
good. Before we go for a break, one more piece of advice on living courageously that you want to give.
Yes,
mm-hmm,
you know, courage is a gift of the Holy Spirit.
Okay,
and we this is to say, we can get this courageousness,
mm-hmm,
or courage,
mm,
from God Himself. It's a gift of God, and so I usually advise young people,
mm-hmm,
to get connected with God.
That's a nice word, get connected.
Get,
huh,
connected.
Mm.
Not in the phone,
yeah,
or online, but spiritual online.
Ultimate source.
Yes, mm-hmm, ultimate source. The spiritual connectedness.
Mm-hmm.
So that God can take control of my life. When I'm completely down, when I find nobody appreciates me, nobody realizes even what I'm doing, you know, that's the time I need to come down,
mm,
and say, where did I come from? Who brought me? I think I have to turn to Him. And that's the greatest source of courage.
Absolutely, yeah.
Yes, yes.
There is one young man here who has said, you know, they are going to reduce, he's going to reduce alcohol and
yeah,
partying,
yeah,
too much.
I liked,
you know,
that actually.
But it's a good resolution,
nice resolution,
isn't it?
Very nice resolution.
And
very concrete one.
Very concrete one.
Yes,
you know,
yes, yes.
So when you say about you know, about the spiritual connection, about rooting yourself in God,
yeah,
I think it's a way of taking care of yourself,
yeah,
so that God can see you, can,
yes,
see you through suffering, and,
yes,
you know, can open ways for you.
Yeah.
But so is it like reducing alcohol? Do you think it's a good suggestion to take care of your body in a more helpful? Is it a good thing to actually take care of your body in a more?
Absolutely, mm-hmm, because,
mm-hmm,
what alcohol does,
mm-hmm,
it stimulates you.
Mm-hmm.
It's a drug, you know.
It's
a drug.
Yeah.
And it does not give you the you know, good health,
mm-hmm,
of mind,
If you take too much, I take stop. I take a bit of it. So
you take a bit of.
Vile unaidescribe manzeni.
Yeah. You know, the other day I was talking. Someone told me I'm a Catholic. I take retro. Mm. But you know that retro, the way it was,
It was.
That guy was even not knowing what he was saying, and he was saying I take retro. So anyway, what I want to say, what I want to say is, yeah. Someone takes a resolution that he's going to leave Hako. Mm. It means that he has seen Hako is a block
to
his growth.
Absolutely.
Or to our growth. And therefore, what I mean is when you take a resolution like that, in fact, you are taking a deliberate kind of action to concentrate more on your well-being than only stimulating yourself.
Correct.
You know, there are many reasons for taking Hako.
It should be for leisure.
But sometimes it could be exaggerated leisure.
Yeah, so yeah. You're
avoiding
something. Okay,
something. Yeah.
Perfect.
So I think it's a very good solution because such a person is taking actually as reflecting as Yako is not doing bad. I mean, good to him.
Anything good to them?
Yes.
Very good.
Yes.
So awesome. Thank you so much, Anastasio. So what I could say from this point is, any pleasure that becomes a prison is no longer a pleasure. Okay. So if something that you've been doing for pleasure has imprisoned you, it's no longer a pleasure, really. Wow. Okay. So I hope you have gotten a few points from Mr. Anastasio, what he's been sharing with us. We're going to take a short break, and when we come back, we'll take a few questions from and read out the comments that you've been making. I'll be having a conversation with my audience also. So keep those comments coming on our Facebook page, some of the resolutions that you've made, something that you are learning from this conversation that we are having today. I would like to hear from you. Right now, I'm going to take it back to Dan, who is going to give us another piece of his beautiful, beautiful music.
All right, so the second song I will sing is called Praises. It's really a song about giving back the praises to God. So it's very simple in the way we sing. So if you guys can help me. So I will be saying, trying to get the tune. So, when praises go up, here we go. Every single day is a blessing from above. Let me get this.
You want to take a short break?
No. Let me just get it. In a minute. Every single day is a blessing from above. Live your life today like you know what is done. Let's take a break.
Okay. All right. So just give him a round of applause. Don't worry. It's all right. We're going to take a short break, kidogo, and we'll come back with the second part. As Dan prepares, we shall take a short break. So don't go away. Keep those comments coming. We'll be back in a few.
Why 254? Imagine.